there's a big difference in the type of feedback that you're going to want to give during the design stage compared to the development stage. While you're in the design stage, you're thinking about this as the framework of a home. So this is more about structurally. Do I have a container at the top that's going to contain promotions because I happen to have a lot of them? Am I going to have a focus area that talks about my maintenance plan because it's really structured, it's a strong program, it's something I want to highlight? Do I want to have an area on the homepage that's featuring a video because you happen to have an amazing video that your owners have shot previously? Do you want to have an area that's going to rotate with testimonials and reviews because you have an amazing portfolio of customer reviews? Maybe you have a special financing program that you want to have a container for. These are all rooms that need to be created inside the design phase. So we need to have a space to hold that asset. Now, what you don't need to do is worry about the actual asset itself. You don't have to worry during the design phase about making sure that the right picture is there or that it's the right video in its place. Technically, it could be a block that says video here, and that would be fine in the design phase. When it comes to the development phase, you want to get into as fast as possible. So the soon as you can approve that design and you say, I've got all the rooms I need in my house, we're good. Let's go ahead and approve this design and let's get into development. That makes sense. When you're in the development phase, this is when you're going to need to start bringing those assets. This is when you're going to make sure that the pictures that are showing on the slider, they're accurate. The promotions that you guys want to showcase, those are accurate. That you are properly showcasing your financing options, whether it's Minecraft or Green Sky and so forth. This is when you're going to want to hand select, what are those reviews that we want to showcase most prominently, or the job posting that we want to showcase in the employment container. Every one of those elements, now in the development time, that's when you're going to want to make those changes. Now, here's the great part. In design, if you were to say, I don't like this picture, I want to change out the picture, you're looking at 24 hours for it to go back to a designer, edit it in Photoshop, and then they have to wait, and it may be 2 or 3 days before you see it again, because it's got to be when you guys both have the time to meet. In the development phase, you can be on the call with your project manager and say, I don't know if I like that picture, and they'll go, no problem, what one do you want to use? You provide the picture, or you find one on iStock, they upload it, and they tell you, refresh, what do you think? Refresh, what do you think? Refresh, what do you think? I don't like the font. Well, let me change the font. Let's move to Roboto or Sans Serif and so forth. And you can literally change your mind on the fly. You can see those changes on the fly. If you try and alter graphics, images, colors, fonts, and so forth in the design phase, it's gonna frustrate you and it's gonna really, really extend your overall project. So get out of design phase quickly, which is framework. We shouldn't even call it design phase. Maybe that's our fault. We need to call it framework. Get out of framework phase, move into development phase, and then that's when you're gonna wanna make those changes. Switch out fonts, colors, images, graphics, videos, promos, anything, and you can do it in minutes. That way you can start to move rapidly and start to get that website done so that you can get an approval and get it live so we can start what matters most, SEO marketing.